DJ Adam. Follow DJ Adam on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at DJ Adam2MV.
So as the title indicated, we are going to be gemming a 20-ounce stainless steel handy slurp tumbler. This particular tumbler I got from the stainlesssteeldepot.com. It was somewhere around $7 or $8, I'm not totally sure, but all of our cups are reasonably priced. Now the cup does come in the bubble wrap and the plastic. I would definitely make sure you save that, especially if you are shipping the cup out. As you can see, it is tapered and stainless steel. There's an acrylic version, but I wanted this one. Well, the customer wanted this one. It has this compartment here on the bottom. It is for what I'm told it's for is like if you need to take any type of pills or maybe you have a powder or you know, like a protein powder or whatever that you want to put in your drink, the compartment is there. I have one of these style cups. I've never used it, but it's convenient, I guess. The lid is a screw top lid, which helps prevent spills. You can just set that aside for now. You're not gonna need it until we get to that portion of the video. Our first step is going to be to sand and prep our cup. I'm using a 220 grit sandpaper. So if you are used to prepping tumblers, just go ahead and sand your tumbler completely, removing that shiny top coat so that our adhesive really has something to grip onto. After you sand your tumbler, go ahead and wash your tumbler. I typically use Dawn dish soap only because I know that it's going to get off all of that residue that's left over after sanding. And then just make sure that your cup is completely dry. As we move into these next steps, all the tools that you see me using are available in my DIY Bling Kit. That Bling Kit is available on my website and I'll put that link down in the description. So the first thing we're gonna want to do is get our adhesive ready. Now, as you can see, I have a glue syringe here with the Aleene's Liquid Fusion. Typically in my kit, I did include this syringe. However, I have, after making this video, I actually realized that for a beginner, trying to fill up the syringe is probably not the easiest thing to do. So I'm going to be switching out the syringes for a precision tip bottle. The precision tip bottle will still come with the 18 gauge tip that you see there in the video. And it'll also come with a 14 gauge tip, which is just something that'll give you a little bit more precision. But during this video, I'll use the syringe. So here's my disclaimer. I did not realize that I was going to be doing this tutorial until after I did the name, so the name is already done. However, I did use my Black Rhinestone Stacker Kit. That is something that is new for my DIY Bling Kit. The stacker comes with 6 different sizes of stones that you can typically use for anything like names or decorations, special designs that you want to put in your rhinestone tumbler. It is literally a stacker, so like the bottom for one is the top for another, but it's just all conveniently there and they are all labeled. So there is the SS4, that is the smallest size you would see. That is the SS6. This is the SS8, SS10, SS12, and SS16. And that's everything that comes available in the stacker for you to use. So I use literally every size here on this name. And as you can see, even though it's black, it still has a really nice shine when the light hits it. And this is indoor lighting, so you know it would be looking very well in the sun. What I did here actually was I cut a piece of vinyl for the name and then I put the stones on top. Just helps it keep those sharp lines. In my 4mm DIY Bling Kit, each kit you will receive enough stones to do the body of a 20-ounce tumbler, but I'll get into that a little bit later. So with the tapered cups, the top is typically bigger than the bottom, but either way, I start at the top with a single line. But the first thing we're going to do is actually wipe this cup down with alcohol. I've been touching it with my bare hands. It's been sitting out in the open. We just want to make sure that there is no type of oils or anything on the cup that will hinder the adhesive from grabbing on to our sanded surface. The next thing I'm going to do is put some gloves on. That way I'm not putting oils back on the cup that I just wiped completely clean. And it leaves no fingerprints. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our syringe. You'll have a precision bottle. Moving forward, there'll be a precision bottle, but we're going to take our syringe and we're going to put our first little line of glue. The reason I liked using a syringe is just what I started out with, but the precision tip really makes it so that you're not wasting glue and glue just getting everywhere and drying up in spots that have no rhinestones. And the reason I like liquid fusion is because it has a pretty good work time. I used to use E6000, but it dried too fast, so I could only put a short line before I had to like hurry up and put stones on. So this wax pickup pen is also available in the kit, and it will come with the pen itself, will have a head on it, and it'll come with two replacement heads. But I've actually had this pen for a little over a year, and it has still been working quite well for me. So as you can see, after you put your line of glue, you just pick up your rhinestones and start placing them. And the reason I like really make sure that I start out with this first line here and I'm very meticulous about it is because it kind of really sets up the pace for how the rest of the cup is going to go. If this first line is crooked, everything down the cup is going to be crooked, and we definitely don't want that. Now, the good and the bad about liquid fusion having the longer work time is that sometimes the stones do shift. So especially on this first line, just make sure that you're keeping an eye on that. If they start slipping, you know, because of gravity, you can just push them up back in place, but eventually the glue will start to really set. You won't really have to worry about that as much. This is the first little bit done. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to speed up this process while I finish out the rest of this line. I'm sorry for going out of frame. When I'm working on these rhinestone cups, I kind of bring it really close to my face or bring it close to my body so I can really see what I'm doing. So when I go out of frame, I do apologize. I'm not doing anything different than what you see when I'm in frame. We're at the end here, and what happened was there is this little bitty gap right between where I started and where I just ended. So what I'm going to do, because I want my first line to be all of the same stones, and because the gap is so small, what you can't see that I'm doing, I apologize again, is I am moving the stones that I just recently did, I'm kind of just moving them a little farther apart. Now, because these are AB stones and it's on a silver cup, even when you spread it a little bit farther apart, you can't really see the cup in between. Like, it won't look like there's an actual gap between the stones that I'm spreading out. It'll just look like everything just fit perfectly, and that's perfect. So if you were using colored stones, what you would do after you sand is you'd actually spray paint the color closest to your stone, and that'll help when you have to do this on a colored cup. But as you can see, you can't really tell where that gap was because I spread everything out. Let's just continue going on here to our next line. There are three different ways that you can lay your rhinestones on your tumbler. One is honeycomb, two is scattered, and three is linear. I really prefer the honeycomb method. I think it is quicker. I think it is neater. My left brain can't wrap my head around the other two methods. So I am doing the honeycomb here. So when you do the honeycomb method, and I'll have to show this to you later because I promise you I'm going to go out of screen. When you do the honeycomb method, you do your next line of glue right on top of that line that you just did. And then each gap, like the space that is formed from two rhinestones, you just set your next rhinestone in that gap. And like I said, I'm going to show you a picture because I kind of forgot that I was doing a tutorial and I forgot to really, you know, zoom in so you can see what I'm doing. But this is the honeycomb method, and it's honeycomb because it has a resemblance to an actual honeycomb, like a beehive, the way that the stones sit in one another. Now, because this is a tapered cup, I will actually be going line by line with these rhinestones. When it is a skinny, straight cup, I'll actually do 5, 6, or 8 lines at a time as I'm going around, because I know I don't have to deal with the cup getting smaller, and I know that each stone is going to fit perfectly in its spot. But right now I'm just doing each line. And here's that picture I promised you. I know it's not the best picture, but you can see how each stone is sitting in the gap that the previous stone provides. Where's that SpongeBob transition when you need it? A little under 5 hours later here, and I have put holes in my glove. I've had to break out my filler tray, which is also available with the DIY rhinestone kit. But here we are. I don't like to rush myself with these cups. Typically on the first day, I'll go about halfway up the cup and, you know, take a break. But look at that shine. This is why I love using glass rhinestones. It is just absolutely gorgeous. And again, remember, this is indoor lighting. So imagine what it's going to look like when the sun hits it. Now, if you notice, right there around the name, I have not filled in any of the stones. I took my SS16 4mm, whatever you want to call it, took it as close as possible, but I actually fill in the name on the last day. It's not something that I feel the need to do as I'm going. It just takes up time. So this is where we've gotten halfway through. Like I said, I did have to break out my filler tray because it's, you know, it's a tapered cup, so it's not the same spacing all the way around. And right here, if my phone would focus, I do have, like, you can see, or I'm trying to show you, that there are filler stones there. So what happens is you do a line and you have to use a filler stone, and then you do a next line and you still have to use a filler stone in that same spot. And what ends up happening is it creates kind of a diagonal until it gets to a point where you can actually take your full stone through a whole line. I haven't figured out a way around that yet, but I mean, it happens, it's there. I'm trying to show another one here, but my phone just won't focus like it needs to. And it's not a flaw, it's not an imperfection, it's just, it is what it is, you know? It's a tapered cup, so. I'm gonna focus a little bit more. You can't really see it. You can feel it on the cup if you're like really looking for it, excuse me. But I mean, it's there. So that's it. That's that. Like I said, I'm not gonna rush myself or anything like that. I am done for the night. I'm going to come back at this tomorrow and we will finish out the rest of it. And we're back. So, as you remember, we had already gotten halfway through it. It is now time to knock out this top half of the tumbler, and then, you know, we'll get to the name and all that stuff. Now, I'm not wearing gloves today. That is because I'm not going to be touching the metal of the cup. I'll only be touching the rhinestones. You can wear gloves if you want. I just didn't feel the need to use resources when I didn't have to. So I'm actually, since I'm in the frame and I'm trying to do better, I'm going to do a couple lines here with you, a couple lines of rhinestones with you, so you can see exactly what I'm doing when I'm, you know, putting these rhinestones on. Still using that wax pickup pen, again, that comes in your rhinestone kit. You'll also be able to see how I do it when I have to use a filler stone. Because at this point it becomes pretty common as the cup continues to get smaller. Now what I do when I get to a space that needs a filler stone, I'll actually skip over that space. My next stone will be where a 4mm or whatever size I'm using. It'll be where it'll actually fit just fine. And then I'll finish out my line of glue because I don't want the glue to dry. And then I'll come back in and I'll fill in with a filler stone. I think I was taking one out that didn't look right. Something was wrong with the stone. But since I had to take it out, I have to put more glue in and then just put a proper stone in its place. As you can see, I skipped that space. I'm just finishing out the line here. So what I'll do now is I'll take my precision tip tweezers, also available in the kit. And I'll pick up one stone to see if it's the size that I need. Because I try to eyeball it, so I'll pick up a stone, see if it's a stone I need. I think I lost it on the cup or something like that. Like it fell out of the tweezers or something. So I filled the space, and then what I just did, there was a really, really small space under it. I took one of the SS3s, which is the smallest filler stone that you have, and I put it right under the other filler, just to make sure that there's no obvious gap. And I hope that makes sense. If you have any question about that, feel free to reach out to me. Like I said, I have one of these tumblers, so I can show you a picture of exactly what I mean when I say that I used you know, I used one of the larger filler stones and then put the SS3 right next to it. I can show you exactly what I mean. Here with you, but I don't want to continue doing it at this slow pace. I know it's not the most exciting thing to watch, so let's just speed up the next couple lines before we get to working on the bottom of the cup.
We could do this all night. I'm feeling worse of B minus, and give it to me right. Baby, we could do this all night.
This cup in the honeycomb pattern. Like I said, honeycomb is very simple, it's very easy. Me, you saw, I still am not going in between the name. I am going to save that for last, but we are almost done. It is looking very nice and shiny. The next thing I'm thinking about here is the bottom, right? So I want to make sure that I have an even line of stones along the bottom. So what I'm thinking about doing is coming from the bottom down to where I'm at right now. Haven't really decided yet, but it is a thought that crossed my mind. Okay, so wait, I changed my mind. I want to make sure that the name is enclosed properly. So I did a few more lines. just making sure that everything is straight and along right by the name, because I've had a cup before where it didn't look good at the bottom of the name and I didn't like it. So I took a couple lines here and I did a line from close to the name to the side. Now I'm just gonna finish that out. I'm gonna do a line around the top and then I'm going to come down. So I've done a few lines here around the bottom edge and it looks nice. It's very even. These few lines, I didn't have to use any fillers at all. It actually went in and on. It went quite nicely. So now I'm just going to fill in the rest of this space with more 4mm rhinestones. So now I have that really small space left. It can only fit in filler size stones. So I filled in right in front of the name, or excuse me, right at the bottom of the name, just so I can see what it's looking like. And so I'm covering up what I haven't done yet, just so I can see if I like the look of it. It's okay. If you're looking for it, you can tell that it's there, but you can't really tell that it's only filler stones there. So I'm just going to go ahead and complete what I've done and finish out the body of this cup. Boom, she is done. Well, so to speak. The main stone part is done. And it looks absolutely gorgeous. I love it. I love it, I love it. Right where my finger is where all those fillers, the last filler stone line went. It took me a while, but I finally came to grips with it. I kind of wish that I would have done it a little bit closer to the bottom, but I like it. I like how it looks. I think it looks beautiful. So the next step that is finished is to work on filling in the name. We'll fill in first where the 4mm can fit, so right there where you can like complete that line all the way over or what have you, right in the gap between that line on the end and the last eye. Let's do that now. I have filled in where the SS16s could really fit. I think I have one more spot I could fit there by the end. But I do this so that I can really just clean up my workspace. I can get rid of the SS16s and really just focus on using fillers and using my filler tray. Now, my filler tray is not filled up the same way as yours would be. It's all the same sizes, but actually some's missing. I don't keep SS16 in my filler tray. And I don't keep as many spots of fillers, but let's get started. So this is what the filler tray looks like. Each individual section opens, you know, individually. I like this particular tray because the tops stay open and then it's really easy to flip back and forth between sizes that are right next to one another. It's super easy, and that is why I chose this tray to put your filler stones in. But most of them are going to come from, you know, the one side with all the smaller stones. So we're going to start right there at the top of the cup, which is basically at the start of the name. You're going to take your syringe, or for people who get the new kit, you're going to take your precision tip bottle, and you're just going to fill in glue where there's empty space around the name. So where the SS16 did not come up and could not meet, you're just going to fill in some glue for your stones. Now what I like to do is I like to take my precision tip tweezers. I will dip them a little bit in the glue, and that'll help me be able to easily pick up the stones out of the filler tray. It's very hard to pick up the stones with the wax tip pencil from the filler tray. That's why you saw me when I was using the SS16, it was sitting right on my desk, because that's just the easiest way to do it. So dip the tip of your tweezers into the glue just a little bit that you've already spread, and then just pick up your fillers. And as you get more used to using these stones, you get used to seeing like exactly what filler you might need for a particular space. Just be careful as you're working, especially with dipping the tweezers into the glue. The glue might start to stick and dry on the tweezers. It's all you have to do is just wipe it off with your fingers. It's really simple. Nothing too difficult. My baby done home and sleeping. Trust me when I tell you, darling. I'm teething a little tonight. I'm teething a little tonight. I'm teething a little tonight. I'm teething a little. So when you see me in the corner, like little Jack Horner, whining. I'm teething a little tonight. I'm teething a little tonight. I'm teething a little tonight. I'm teething a little. So when you see me in the corner, like little. Do keep in mind, you won't be able to fill in every single space. There will be some spaces where even the SS3 will not fit, and that is okay. Do not freak out about it, or, you know, beat yourself up over it. It's just what it is, you know, but you won't even be able to tell. When the cup is all said and done, you will barely be able to tell that there's any space around this name. So do not beat yourself up over that. Just fill in what you can, leave what you can't, and enjoy your masterpiece. Everybody done wet, we just done wet, we back done wet, we out of breath, we pelting ways and we can't done yet, no, we can't done yet. We face done wet, we dripping sweat, we drinks in the air, so the place done wet. Call our next rounds, everything done set. The sun not out, so we can't done yet. Somebody say, oh, 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 hey, 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 hey. Live me life, live me life. Oh, 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 hey, 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 hey. Live me life, live me life. And that's that on that first little section. My phone won't focus like I needed to, but look how filled in it is and how nice it is with your filler stones. So let's sweep this up.
I always happy once money in the hand. But I don't got no time for no worries. I don't got no time for no stress in my head. One on my mind, so I'm ready to go on the road. I come out to live my life. Live my life, play a mass and live my life. I'm the happiest man alive. I come out to live my life. Live my life, drink a rum and live my life. I'm the happiest man alive. Somebody say, whoa, oh, 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 yeah, 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 yeah. Live my life. Live my life. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, 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 yeah. Live my life. Live my life.
Just wanted to do the beginning of the end with you guys, and look how filled in and how neat it is. It's part of the reason why I use vinyl, but I will come back to you guys when this is all said and done. Just putting on these last little bit of rhinestones here. And just look at how nice that looks when you trust the process. It's so beautiful and filled in. Ah! Sorry. I love taking something from nothing to something, so I'm just so happy with this finished product. Now, if you remember, I did take SS16 previously, and I took it all the way around the top of the K to the bottom of that I, but I switched it out. I decided to do something a little different and use smaller stones. It just looked better with the little rhinestones that went under the dot of the I. Yeah, I just think that the smaller rhinestones look better. But I think this looks great. As far as the font, if anyone wants to know, the font is Wolf's Bane Pro. I believe I got it off of DaFont, and I used an offset of 0.015. I use Silhouette software. I don't know how to do it in Cricut. I'm sorry, but yeah. But that's it. That's it for the body. Let's move on to the top. We are moving on to the top. As you can see, we have our gloves back on so we can make sure not to get any oils on the top. It is already scuffed up because I've already sanded it and I've already washed it, but we're just going to double back over ourselves or what have you and wipe it down once again with some alcohol just to make sure that there's absolutely nothing on the surface. Now, if you remember earlier, I said that you do get enough stones in your kit to do a 20-ounce tumbler. That is the body of the tumbler. Most people start with a 20-ounce skinny just because it's easier to work with. But if you do choose a 20-ounce dome tumbler, there are not enough stones in the kit to do the body and the top. What I actually did was I measured out 7 gross of the stones just to see if that was enough to get the top. And I ended up using a little over 7, but not completely 8. The glass stones are measured out in packs of 10 gross. So if you buy a 10 gross pack off Amazon, it'll be enough to do your entire tumbler. So I also have my filler tray kit open to my 12 and my 10 SS, just if I need any fillers for the tumbler, as well as, as well as the rim. The rim, we're most likely going to be doing the 10, we're going to be doing the SS10, but for right now, we're just going to start with the top, we're going to do the rim, and then we're going to just go down, down, down until it's finished. Gloves on, and let's get started. I like to make sure that every possible part of my rhinestone tumbler is covered in rhinestones. So these first two lines that I'm about to do here, you don't have to do them. I choose to do them. It just makes it seem like it's more of a complete project. So I spread my glue out and I just put on the SS16 rhinestones in a circle right there at the top. If ever you're using your wax pickup pencil and it stops picking up the rhinestones as easily as it should, you can always just wipe the pen on a piece of cloth. Most likely it just has a bunch, it's just needs to be cleaned. So that's the first line, and now we're going to do the second line. And if you notice, there wasn't enough space in that first line that I did, and I just kind of pushed everything around, moved it around so I can fit in that one last stone. I really don't like using fillers on the top. I prefer to keep it as uniform as possible. It's really hard with the body of the tumbler, but with the top, it's a little easier to maneuver. And what I'm going to try on my next tumbler that I'm able to do, if someone orders one, I'm going to try actually working from the bottom of the tumbler to the top and see if that helps with not needing as many fillers. As you can see, working from the top of the tumbler, you go from the smallest to the biggest, and that's why I'm able to, you know, not use as many fillers. So I'm gonna try that out the next time I get a chance and see how that works out. And plenty action. When you wind your waist and screw your face, I could feel your passion. Girl, you got plenty vibes and plenty action. You're taking me higher, igniting me fire. When you wind like that, right there, keep going like that, right there. You know I want you, so baby, don't front low. Just start to push back, right there. Walk up on the spot, right there. Girl, I want you wind and bend down low. You're raising my body temperature and putting my heart under pressure. Thank you for joining me on that journey. So the top is almost done, just coming down to the last few stones here as we approach the bottom edge. And I think I only used like maybe 2 or 3 fillers. I really didn't use that many. Spreading them out a little bit more really just helped. So like I said, next time I do a tumbler, I'm gonna try and go from the bottom. Next time I do a taper tumbler, I'm gonna try to go from the bottom to the top. But that is that, looking just as gorgeous as the tumbler itself. Now, as you can see, there is a gap down there at the bottom right before the lip, but I'm actually going to focus on that top edge first before I deal with that gap. And that's just me seeing if the 4mm stone will fit there, and it'll fit just fine. So I'm going to glue around the edge and get the top, then we'll work on that gap right under that last little bit of, right under that last line of stones. This soca music, how she feeling naughty? Mm-hmm. Cause this is the time, this is the line. Say the words with all your friends and we join. Cause it's about love, so show me a sign. Carnival, we in the streets and it is yours and mine. I don't even want to say, come girl, I'm fine on it. 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 Hey. So the top is done. Well, most of the top is done. And it is looking just as gorgeous as the tumbler itself. I put another hole in my glove with my nails. But so I finished that edge with the 4mm stones. I also filled in that gap that I was showing you that was just under the last line of stones. I used SS8, and in between each SS8 is an SS3. And that filled it in perfectly. You can't really see any gaps. And now we're going to work on that edge. On the edge, I already measured it out. I'm going to be using SS12, which is smaller than the SS16, but it's basically right there. You know, it's only like a millimeter or two smaller. But I found that that is what will fill in that edge perfectly with three rows of the stones. And now you'll be able to see how I work when I do a skinny tumbler. So I'm just gonna apply my glue. The amount of stones that I have measured out there, I actually measured out 8 gross of the SS8, but you won't need that much. You'll need minimum 3 gross. Now, unfortunately, in the kit is only 2 gross that you get in your filler tray. So again, if you are working on a dome style tumbler where you are also doing the lid, you'll need to get an extra bag of the SS8 if you plan on doing your lid for your dome tumbler. If you're not going to do it, then you don't really need it. But a rhinestone tumbler that is a dome lid without rhinestones on the dome, trust me, it does not look good. We spread our glue, we're putting on the rhinestones, and you don't really have to go one line at a time. You can just stack them how they need to be stacked. And it's still honeycomb. It's still honeycomb pattern that I'm putting on there. It's just I don't have to go line by line because on this particular portion of the lid, it's straight up and down. It's not tapered. But what you will need to make sure you do is make sure that the stones are completely flat on this section of the lid and that nothing is really hanging over, because that part will be grabbed most often. If they're picking up the cup, if they're taking off the lid or what have you, you don't want a stone that's hanging over that can get knocked multiple times, because it will get knocked off. Like I said, I test these things out on myself before I sell them. So I made my own tumbler and I had stones hanging off that edge and they did come off, and I had to just replace them with a smaller stone. So rather than doing that, that's why I just measured out and I figured out that the SS8 is what is going to fit on here and fill it properly. Now I put a little bit too much glue on this section, which is why my stones are really just moving so much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my syringe, I'm going to use the tip of my syringe, and I'm actually just going to kind of scrape off a top layer of the glue and just move it to the end. So basically I'm just spreading the glue out a little more. And instead of using a brush or something like that, I use the tip of the syringe because I can just wipe it. I can just wipe it off on some cloth and the tip will be clean. So I am going to work on the rest of this, and while I do that, please enjoy some more soca. You're way too late to let it go, oh, oh, so enjoy yourself and let it show, oh, show. We are true masqueraders and we have no behavior. Come on, let me drink it up. Right. now to this last little section here, I'm actually going to put one line of glue on the bottom line because I'm really just trying to see if the spacing is perfect on this lid and if I can get the SS12s to just fit all around properly. But as I will find out, the last space will not fit an SS12. So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna have to use one of my fillers to just fill in that last space right there between where I started and where I ended. And the only reason I have to do that is because the gap is too big to try and spread out the stones to make it work. So just gonna fill in this glue here to do my last little bit of SS12s. And now that that's done, now I need to figure out what will fit in the space that's left. Sorry to go off screen again, but like I said, I sometimes just have to really bring it close to my face. But from what I can see here, it looks like the SS8s are what's gonna fit in that space, so we just drop some glue and put the SS8 stones. And again, I mean, with these fillers, it's one of those things where you fill it in with the smaller stone, and unless you're actually looking for it, you won't be able to tell that there's smaller stones there. Now, what I did try to do, I tried to see if the gap or the spacing between the stones was too much, and see if maybe I can fit in an SS3 just to, you know, make sure you're seeing even less of the silver backing or what have you. But what happened was I tried an SS3 and it pushed the stones too much. So it pushed it to where stones were over the edge. And like I said, you really don't want that. So I ended up taking the SS3 out and just making sure that the spacing between the stones was well enough that it looked very uniform. That is it, guys. The lid is finished. It is beautiful. It is gorgeous. It is going to look so nice on the cup. Leave your cup and your lid to dry for a few days. Give that glue time to cure so that you don't have any mishaps.
What I'm going to show you now is just a few still shots of the cup that you may not have been able to see properly in the video. This first picture here is a picture of the top rim. You can better see the honeycomb pattern and how the stones are laid out on the cup. And you can also see how I place the first line along the rim. This picture here is the filler stones on the actual cup itself. You can see just how it creates that diagonal line I was talking about. This is a close-up of the name, all the filler stones around the name, and you can see the gaps. Like I said, don't stress it. It looks great as a finished product. Right there in the middle of the screen, that is the filler stone line that goes around the entire cup right under the name. Just wanted to see you to see what that looks like. This here is a picture of the top of the cup right around the hole. Like I said, you don't have to do it. I just like that complete look. This is the bottom edge of the lid, so you can see the filler stones that I used. You can see the SS12s right along the outside. You can also see the SS16s that sit on the top edge. This is just a closer look, and in this shot you can also see where I placed the two filler stones on the lid. Of course, I had to go outside and get a video of this gorgeous cup in the sunlight, and that shine is just out of this world. I even sent a video to Nikki, of course, because I do that with all of my cups, and she was in love. It's actually en route to her right now as I edit this video, so I'm just very excited and happy with how it turned out. If you made it this far, thank you for joining me on this journey. If you have any questions whatsoever, definitely feel free to reach out to me. You can either drop your question down in the comments. I am on Instagram. I am on Facebook. I have a WhatsApp number. I will put all of that information in the description below. I'll see you guys next time.
Me pull up and I'm a Chris girl. In front the club like a big star. In a me Louis Vuitton and me G-star. Hide a wife, your daughter's...